Hey guys, good morning. It's me, Callie. Look at me coming at you from my webcam. What a week it's been, my darlings. Oh my goodness. You know, it started out with a bang and it just continued. And I shared with you guys on Wednesday, some of the, you know, that I was having a difficult time with some of my children and just hard for me being a parent, you know, and I had gone over to visit this week and, you know, so everybody's okay. It's going to be okay, right? Good stuff. And in the middle of the week, I never remember my dreams, or I rarely remember my dreams. I just don't. I sleep very heavily, and it's a rare occasion if I remember what I dreamt of the night before. I woke up, I think it was Wednesday morning, from a dead sleep, sat up in bed, and said to Tom, I just dreamt that my mother passed away. And it just gripped my heart, you know, and And I even, my mom's on Facebook, you know, I even sent her a little I love you message that morning. Just, you know, I love you, Mom. I didn't tell her what my dream was, you know. And it just gets you thinking. And I shared with you, sometimes I feel guilty that I don't spend a lot of time with my friends and things like that. But I spend more time with them than I do my own family. It's just my mother and my sister and I, besides children, obviously, and things like that. And I love them both dearly, and I don't ever want to take them for granted, but I'm not a big visitor, and, you know, thank goodness for social media and stuff, we stay in touch, but anyway, my mom lives in Pennsylvania. I'm in New York State, so it's not like it's the other side of the world, but she's not right next door. But anyway, this is my guilt talking, right? So I have this dream, and I'm like, oh my goodness, you know, I got to go see my mom, you know? Friday, I'm visiting at my daughter's house, and I get a phone call from my sister. And like I just said, it's not like we all spend a lot of time together, and so it's kind of like, ugh. I answer the phone, and sure enough, she tells me, not that my mother passed away, but that my mother, thank goodness, that my mother was in the hospital. And literally, my heart stopped in my throat, and I was like, oh my God, I just had this dream, is she going to be okay? And prayers and love going out to my mom. Bad case of pneumonia. My sister and I went to see her yesterday. And, you know, it's... I love my mother. I'm not going to have a sad vlog here, but it just emotionally has been a roller coaster week. And my mom's improving. She's, you know, getting better as we speak. They're talking discharge soon. It's not going to be an extended stay. Knock wood. Things will continue to improve. But I've been wiped out emotionally. Good side of it is, you know, I mean, my sister, my mother, and I had a 4-hour visit in the hospital yesterday, and, you know, crisis either drives people apart or brings people together, and we come together in our family. So one of the benefits is that I did get to spend time with my sister yesterday and my mom, and I'll be making more frequent trips to Pennsylvania, but I did not go to the auction last night. I got home, I don't know what time, probably right around the time that we would be going. And I touched base with Tom and Nick, who've been nothing but supportive. And Tom's been on standby, ready to help at a second's notice, and is a help at every minute. But we were just all wiped out, really, this week. So we did not go. And that's okay. And I touched base with everyone. And, you know, Patty, sweet Patty, and hi, Kat. And everybody, I love all you guys. Patty just gave me love and support and reminded me that, you know, these things happen, and they just kind of a reminder to stay grateful and be thankful every second. And I, you know, you guys know I try to live that every day. I think I do live that fairly well, but still, you know, you get caught by surprise sometimes. You can be, you know, la 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 la, and life is still happening all around you. So oh, and also, you know, when it rains, it pours, and that's, you don't want to ask, you know, can it get any worse? Because yes, it can always get worse, and this is, you know, nothing compared to so much of what people are going through. I get it, you know. But on top of everything else, my phone had been acting up all week. And you guys know, or maybe don't know, but I rely on my phone for the camera mostly. I'm not a big phone person, but if I use my phone, I use it for the internet and for social media and my camera. I'm so reliant on it. So a couple of days ago, it started acting really funny. It was freezing up and processes were shutting down and it wasn't working and it was just not acting right. It took the battery out, took the SIM card out, messed around with it. It's been really acting up. So my phone has put, yesterday I thought I actually got it. Tom, God bless him, even, you know, he's like troubleshooting over the phone with me. But he went online and found out that other people had been having problems and maybe I should just like go back to the factory settings on the phone, which I don't care. I really, unfortunately or fortunately, all of my pictures and things like that are backed up on Facebook. So there wasn't a lot that I was worried about losing. I can always reload apps again. So I did reset it all to the factory settings, and I thought at one point that we had it. And then this morning again, before I knew I have a lot of videos, a lot of filming I need to do this week, right? That I want to do this week. So I thought I had it, but no, alas, it is not working. So I said, don't frustrate yourself with it anymore. I don't need to deal with it today. Thank goodness I have a webcam, right? And I've been meaning to, this is kind of forcing me to use the, I always use the YouTube editor, but you know, different aspects of that I've been a little afraid of, so it's forcing my hand. I did just finish, and P.S., I'll get the phone fixed this week. It's not going to be a big deal. Like I said, luckily I have the computer, I have a webcam, I have everything I need, and I also have a landline phone. I don't have cell service where I'm at anyway, but I do have a landline if I need to, you know, reach anyone or anything, so. But it was just a topper to the week, you know. I'm like, oh my goodness. So I got home last night and I saged and smudged everywhere and just like, ah, you know, took a shower, let it all drain away, and let's, you know, follow up and have a good week. So that's where I'm at right now. Like I said, it was really nice to spend time with my sister yesterday. I have many women in my life that I call my sisters, but I only have one biological sister, my sister Sue, and I love her, and you know, she's 5 years older than I am, so nobody shares your own memories like your siblings, you know, and I'm blessed. My sister and I fought like cats and dogs growing up, but as adults, we are close, and I adore her, and she gave me a present, and I'm going to share with you what she got me, and I've wanted this. I can't tell what you're seeing. I'm used to having the camera that I'm looking at that I could see myself when I'm filming. So now I have you guys here up on the tripod and my computer is next to me. So I'm seeing my face down at the side while I'm talking to you. So it's disconcerting. So anyway, she got me this. And I had seen, she got my mother one of these for Christmas. And I believe she also has one. So I've seen this before and I secretly wanted one. So check this out, you guys. It's a bowl, obviously, right? But look at this hole here. Do you guys know what this is? It goes all the way around. It's indented in the bowl. It's pottery. It's gorgeous. I'm in love with it. And shout out to, I'll show you what it's used for in a minute. These are handmade yarn bowls by New Moon Studios. Okay, you put the thread through the slot and then the bowl keeps the yarn from unrolling. So let's check this out, right? Here's my bowl and I grabbed some yarn that I got from Allie not too long ago. Put it in and you take it and you just thread your yarn through this here. And so you can knit, hello, and your yarn won't get old. Now, obviously, if you have cats and kittens, they will think that this is a toy just for them. But I, for the first time in my life, don't have any cats right now. I love this. Sue, thank you so much. You know how much I love it. And I'm just going to keep this out. It sparked joy, like, immediately and forever. and I'm going to keep this out in the house, and maybe it's time to do some knitting. So, again, shout out to New Moon Studios, and yeah, so that's that. Yeah, and also with using this webcam, I just finished, and I'll show you guys, you know, I do the Mission Inspiration challenges. Shout out to Mike Deacon. I'll put a link below. I just finished his April mission. So this is, I use my, this is a Diana Reevely Delusions journal, right? And I've done, this is April, so I've done four. This was January's mission. This was February's mission. Picture is a poem without words. Here is la 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 la. March's. Great acts are made up of small deeds. And then I just finished this morning, and I just posted the video. Here is April's. And it says, happiness is the side effect of a good heart. And, yeah. So, but with using the, now my web, the technological difficulties, YouTuber problems, right? I've come a long way, baby, but I still have a long, long way to go. Oh, and before I forgot, speaking of long way to go, shout out to Cinnamon Cooney, Cinnamon and John, who have been selected to be part of this specialized YouTube training, and they're actually coming to New York for a week. Is that true? Well, hello, you guys. I live right by the Woodstock Festival site. Don't you want to come to Bethel and check out the Woodstock site and hang out with your friend Callie? Open invitation, Cinnamon. I know you guys are going to be busy, but I would love to see you. And congratulations. That is astounding news. I'm so excited. So shout out to Cinnamon Cooney and her husband, John. Shout out to the Creative Arts Collaboration, of which I am a proud member of. And shout out to YouTube for enriching people's lives and allowing them to grow and experience opportunities that would not be possible without them. So I'm really psyched for Cinnamon and John, and I can only expect more great things from them both. So that's so cool to see a friend, you know, succeeding and making it. It's so great. I'm so excited. And what an encouraging, wonderful group. And speaking of the CAC, there's one project that I'm going to be working on today after we finish, after I finish this video today for this week. And then, of course, I have the Gypsy and the Witch page I'm working on. And then another creative arts collab project due coming out at the end of the month. But with using my, back to the webcam, Callie, with using the webcam, which is great, I told you guys that I had problems, that Nick had bought me a mic, and it wasn't working. So right now, until I get the settings down, and I'll have Tom look at it again, the video that I just posted for April's Mission Inspiration, while visually it was fine and I'm happy with it, it sounded like I was in an echo chamber. And so I was really not happy with the sound. So please, I don't even know how the sound's going to come out on this video today. Please bear with me while I'm still working it out. And someday I'll be making enough money on YouTube that I can actually afford good camera equipment, etc. So put that thought out into the universe and manifest that, right? So, but that's good stuff. And so I worked on that. I told you I'm going to be working on one project will be coming out this week. I think on the 14th I'm going to release it. And what else? I've been doing the, I showed you guys in April my, I mentioned the doodle a day, and I forgot to give a shout out. I did when I first did it, but it's Sea Lemon, and I'll put her channel below. She's very well known here, and she issued an April Doodle a Day challenge. So I have been doing just pencil in this little journal that someone gifted me. I either got this in Happy Mail, or maybe one of my daughters or a friend I don't know, someone gifted me this journal. It's just a plain white journal, and I'm using pencil, and so I've been doing a doodle a day, and like I said, I'll link Sea Lemon's channel below. I gotta remember this. Cinnamon, Sea Lemon, Syllabus. This was the first one, and I'm behind. P.S. I'm behind. So, first day was Unicorn, and I love to doodle, and I love to draw, but it's just, it's been a hectic week, so you guys know. So I'll catch up at some point. Second day was Houndstooth, which made me insane. Third day was Clouds, which we've all had our Judy Collins reference. I told you I wasn't so happy with that one. The fourth day was a fish, and they came out cute. The fifth day was feathers, which I told you I struggled with initially. They all looked like leaves. Sixth day was eye. I think the eyebrow, you know, I could pick these apart. Look how close I did the eyebrow to the eye. But whatever. The seventh day, she rested, no, was nature. The eighth day was emoji. And, you know, I'm looking at, look how crooked the mouth is, but that's okay. I'm a little crooked myself. So, and then the ninth day, which was yesterday, which I did not do, is pizza. And the word for today is planet. So I'll be doing pizza and planet at some point. Pizza planet point. So that's that. And what else? I'm looking at my list. Okay, I know what I wanted to talk about. Please bear with me. You guys know, I keep it real with you guys. I share pretty much everything in my life. When I filmed What's Up Wednesday on Wednesday, I told you, I mentioned to you guys that I lost some footage when I was on the way to my lab appointment, and I hadn't remembered what I was talking about. Well, I remembered what I was talking about, and I still want to talk about it because it's relevant and it's ongoing right now. This has to do with mailing packages overseas, and I'll be open and honest about it. This is about Mr. Victor Crafter. Victor, I love you, brother, and I'm going to talk about your Happy Mail package, that I want to send to you. Victor blessed me, I'll link his channel too. For those of you who don't know Mr. Victor Crafter, Victor lives in the Ukraine. He is one of my first subscribers here on YouTube. He is a well-loved member of the YouTube crafting and arting community. He is so supportive to all of his fellow artists, and he's well-loved, and check him out. I'll put his channel below. I had the honor of receiving some amazing Happy Mail from Victor not too long ago, a few weeks ago. Just incredible artwork that he crafted with his own hands and made with a lot of love, and it was my first package ever from the Ukraine, and just very exciting, and how amazing and wonderful to have a friend. So I told you guys, if you send me Happy Mail, I will always reciprocate. So I made up a package for Victor. Now, I'm not ignorant. I understand that shipping costs overseas are, it's expensive. I get it. I've mailed things to the United Kingdom before that have cost me, you know, I understand that it can be expensive. First of all, there's no flat rate shipping to Russia, okay? It doesn't exist. So it's based on weight. When my package, I gave it to Tom to mail, and he came home and he said to me that in that package to mail to where I need to mail it to Victor would cost over $90, $90 US, so close to $100. There is no way at this time that I can afford even close to, and Victor, I'm not, I'm just stating the facts. I want to be able to give you this package, but there is no way that I can do this, right? Cannot afford it at all, not even close, just can't do it. So then I said, okay, well, let's find a way around this. What would be, now, and then I told you, we're friends with our local postmaster, right? So if I'm going to get straight information, I'm going to get it from Joe. Shout out to Joe. How can this be done? I want to mail something. The lowest rate of under 5 pounds and under to where I need to mail it to will cost me $54. $54. I can't do it, Victor. I could cry right now. I can't do this, brother. Even, and I said, it doesn't matter what it weighs. You mean, even if I mailed this piece of paper, it's going to cost me $54? Yes, it's going to cost $54. I'm heartbroken about this. Victor, please forgive me. I wish, you know, I'm going to use all of my witchy powers to come up with a way around this, if it's possible. But at this point, brother, I cannot mail you anything. I cannot afford it. I'm giving you all of my love for free right now over the airwaves, but I'm heartbroken about this. Now, what I want to ask my fellow YouTube subscribers, and if you want to keep this anonymous, that's fine, but I do know that some of you have mailed packages to Victor. He's gotten happy mail from you guys, so I know it's been done. Is there something I'm missing here? Is there a way that I can, you know, not have to turn the lights off to send a package? If you guys feel comfortable, those of you who have mailed happy mail to Victor, if you feel comfortable sharing with me, maybe something that I'm missing, but I've talked, Tom specifically has talked to two different postmasters regarding this, and that's the answer that I've been giving, that it's going to cost $54 to mail even a postcard to Russia. So I am sorry, my brother. Cost is prohibitive at this time. So unless, again, there's something that I don't know, that's what I wanted to tell you, and that's what I was discussing on the way to get my labs done the other day. So I'm heartbroken about it. I wish it weren't so, but that's what I've been told, so I have to believe that. So at this time, there is no package coming from me to you right now, and I hate to even say that. But listen, you guys, this has probably been just not a very uplifting video, but it is what it is, and life is what it is. And again, I am blessed. If you know, let this be the worst week I ever have. You know, I'm surrounded by love. I love you guys. You lift me up every day. I'm inspired by all of you, by your artwork, by your stories, by your support. You know, more and more, I just am so enriched and blessed and have changed in only positive ways. So I'm going to go heat up some Indian. I made a cool recipe, like kind of combined. You guys know I love Indian food. So I made some aloo matar gobi, which is that potatoes, cauliflower. Look at me saying goodbye now. I'm telling you about food. You know me, right? It's potatoes, cauliflower, and peas, like Indian dish, spicy. And I also love chana bhuna, which is chickpeas in a spicy sauce. Well, I figured if I love those two, they got to be great together, right? So I kind of whipped up my own recipe of the aloo matar gobi mixed with the chana bhuna, and it came out amazing. And I've been kind of eating it all week, just heating it up over rice. So I have a little bit left. I'm going to heat that up again. And we were going to go to the Fiddle Fest today. Remember I mentioned to you that we had gone for the last couple years to the Fiddle Fest? Not even going to do that today, you guys. Just need time to regroup, to heal a little bit. I'm going to give my mama a call in a little while, make sure she's doing okay. I just appreciate you guys so, so much. Stay tuned. Check out my Mission Inspiration video. I've already posted that up. That's like out there this morning, and then I'll probably have another one. I definitely will have a couple more this week. So Got to get started on that Gypsy and Witch page, too. I love you guys so, so much. Thank you again for all your support and love. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. If you have not yet subscribed, I would love it if you do. And I'll talk to you guys really soon, okay? I love you guys. Take care. Bye-bye.